डिस्कस अबाउट रीसेंट ब्रेक थ्रू इन सॉफ्ट टिश्यू एंड बोनी सार्कोमास. कैन आई हैव नेक्स्ट स्लाइड प्लीज? या सो दिस इज एक्सट्रीमली हेटरोजीनस एंड टू वेरीगेटेड एंड इट्स एक्सट्रीमली रेयर, अनलाइक लंग कैंसर विच वी हैव डिस्कस्ड एंड वी हैव गॉन थ्रू इन डिटेल्स इन लास्ट फ्यू प्रेजेंटेशंस. सार्कोमा नाउ इट इज कैन नॉट बी क्लासिफाइड और लम्प टूगेदर, दे आर ऑलमोस्ट 200 सब टाइप्स. सो वी मस्ट अंडरस्टैंड विच सब टाइप आर वी टॉकिंग अबाउट. सो एज वी नो दैट इन सम सार्कोमास पेजोपेनिप दैट इज नॉन एडिपोसिटिक, एंजियोसार्कोमा इज टोटली डिफरेंट लाइन्स, आई एम एफ टी, ए एस पी एस, पिकोमास, लाइपोसार्कोमास, कॉर्डोमास, एपिथेलॉइड सार्कोमास, नाउ इम्यूनोथेरेपी. सो आई विल कम टू देम वन बाय वन. कैन आई माय नेक्स्ट स्लाइड प्लीज? सो द अप्रूव थेरेपीज नाउ आर पेजोपेनिप, ट्रेबेक्टिडीन, हिस्टोलॉजी बेस्ड थेरेपीज, एरिबुलिन एंड इम्यूनोथेरेपी. नेक्स्ट स्लाइड प्लीज. सो दिस इज द 2016 फिगर विच शोज दैट these were the three drugs which were approved. Pazopanib, which was actually targeting VEGFR receptor, trabectedin, which was actually binding to minor groove, eribulin, which was a mitotic spindle inhibitor. Next, please. So this is the registration trial for Pazopanib. It was advanced sarcomas, non-adipositic. It was compared against placebo. And next slide, please. We saw there was a PFS benefit. Next slide, please. And based upon this PFS benefit of 3 months, it was approved. This is an oral drug. It is very well tolerated drug. So I'll just tell about Indian experience or Indian data with every drug of whatever I will discuss. Next slide, please. So this is our data. It was in early 19. We had 33 patients and median PFS was 5 months. This was a retrospective study. This could lead to inflation of PFS by 1 or 1.5 months. So otherwise, it was again well-tolerated drug. Next slide, please. Our toxicity was mainly hand-foot syndrome, which was as compared to West, this was very less common toxicity there. Otherwise, rest, everything was fitting into the typical picture. Next slide, please. So this is updated data, which was presented e-posted in ASCO 2019. There were 66 patients. Median PFS was still 5 months. However, the dose which our patients tolerated was 400 mg, even without financial constraints. So probably the dose, though in the pellet trial, it was 92% of patients received 800 mg. So that is something to think about. Next slide, please. So another, next slide, please. Yeah, so I'll just go to trabectedin, which is the next in line. In 2012, pazopanib was approved by FDA. Then in 15, trabectedin was FDA approved. Next slide, please. So trabectedin registration trial as compared to pazopanib was an actively controlled trial. The population was leiomyosarcoma and liposarcomas. And as you can see, it was 2:1 randomization. Primary endpoint was overall survival compared with dacarbazine. Next slide, please. So again, the PFS benefit was almost same as of pazopanib. Based upon PFS benefit, it was FDA approved. Next slide, please. So we were very skeptical about it. So we wrote to JCO that based upon this much of PFS benefit without quality of life benefit and without any prognostic biomarker and with such a heterogeneous group, pleomorphic liposarcoma, myxoid liposarcoma, leiomyosarcoma, dedifferential liposarcoma, and so it's always good to connect with Indian data. Next slide, please. So another indication or not so approved indication for trabectedin is translocation related sarcoma. So this was a phase 2 trial in which it was compared with best supportive care. Mind you, this was after multiple therapy lines. Primary endpoint was progression free survival. Next slide, please. In this trial, trabectedin showed dramatic improvement in PFS as compared to best supportive care after as good as 5 or 6 lines when nothing was working. So it probably works in translocation-related sarcomas, including synovial, Ewing's, clear cell, ASPS. Next slide, please. However, for this indication, this is not FDA approved. This is our AIM data. Again, there were 20 patients on trabectedin till 2019. And Majority of them were lipo and leiomyosarcoma, just like registration trial, L-sarcomas. Next slide, please. So as you can see the curves, after some time the curves plateau. So there is a fraction of patients which went on for having prolonged responses. Next slide, please. Of 20 patients, 6 patients did well for 1 year or more. 3 of them were leiomyosarcoma, one of them were myxoid liposarcoma, and 2 of them were translocation-related sarcoma. Next slide, please. And the toxicity were, again, they were well tolerated, though, and it corresponds to this the registration trial. Next slide, please. And now, this was a paper that was published by Dr. Shofsky, that for trabectedin, we don't even require 24-hour admission, and we can give it via disposable elastomeric pump. Now in AIMS, we are giving the disposable elastomeric pump. Next slide, please. So I'll just go through a case quickly. This was a patient of metastatic leiomyosarcoma, partial response on pazopanib, which we published. Next slide, please. On multiple lines of therapies. And this is baseline. This is after 3 months. This is after 17 cycles. So even after 17 cycles, the lesion will remain same. And it is a non-cumulative drug. Unlike alkylating agents or unlike anthracyclines, it is a non-cumulative. We have given as much as 25 or 30 cycles as well. Next cycle, please. This is also, as I told you, this is very, it provides good benefit in translocation-related sarcoma. But of those translocation-related sarcoma, this paper was published in BMC saying that it particularly acts well in extraskeletal myxoid chondrosarcoma and mesenchymal chondrosarcoma with PFS of 12 months versus 1 month. Next slide, please. So we had a patient of mesenchymal chondrosarcoma of this cohort. It was treated like Ewing sarcoma, had partial response, followed by progressive disease, was given lipodox, again progressive disease, was started on trabectedin-based protocol. Next slide, please. So this is the baseline lesion. This is the pre-trabectedin. This is after 1 year. After 1 year, the size of lung nodule was same. Even the primary lesion was same. However, it progressed rapidly after stopping after that because patient progressed on trabectedin. And this is a published report. So this was mesenchymal chondrosarcoma, which has translocations. Next slide, please. So probably pazopanib and trabectedin are done. Now we'll come to the vast majority of STS, in which histologies are so many. Next slide, please. As we know, propranolol is the upcoming in vascular tumors. Next slide, please. So this is a patient of infantile solid fibrous tumor, pre-propranolol based therapy, post-propranolol based therapy. Next slide, please. And as you can see, patient had excellent response and is now a survivor. Next slide, please. At some point of time, it was unresectable. It is a patient of angiosarcoma. Again, this propranolol-based regimen works very well in angiosarcoma. This is one of our patients who had excellent response for almost more than 1 year in metastatic setting, as you can see. Next slide, please. Simultaneously, we have few other sarcomas which are actually chemotherapy resistant, DFSP. Metastatic DFSP is extremely rare cancer, and this is maybe third or fourth paper with 7 or 8 patients. And in this, imatinib gives excellent outcome, but histopathology has to be very impeccable, because if it is something else, it will not respond to imatinib, and DFSP doesn't respond to any other therapy. We had 71% response rates, and now we have translocation also available for DFSP here. Next slide, please. So ASPS responds to TKIs, responds to immunotherapy. This patient, progressive ASPS, responded to sunitinib for 2 years. Next slide, please. So this is IMFT, which is ALK positive. It was ALK positive by FISH as well as IHC, and this is pre and post crizotinib. Almost complete response. Patient is still in CR for last 1 year. Next slide, please. So again, like Corduma, which we think that it might not respond to therapies. It is EGFR positive, and this mutation is not there. However, expression is there. And if it is EGFR positive, it responds very well to erlotinib. Next slide, please. There are a lot of reports now with erlotinib. And this is a next slide, please. Next 2 slides, please. This is a patient who has started on erlotinib. This is pre-therapy. As you can see, these big masses. And this is post-therapy. Patient still, after 12 months, still doing well in CR. Next slide, please. So again, tazemetostat is the newest drug which is approved in 2020 for INI-negative epithelioid sarcoma. Next slide, please. Based upon a trial of 62 patients, it was a phase II trial, basket trial, in which response rate was 15%. Next slide, please. However, it maintained till a long time. So next slide, please. We have currently two patients on tazemetostat. Next slide, please. Next slide, please. Next slide, please. The dose is 800 mg BD. It's an oral drug with quite good tolerable profile. Next slide, please. So we had a patient of epithelioid sarcoma, INI negative, recurrent metastatic setting. Again, tazemetostat started on compassionate basis. Next slide, please. This is loss of INI. Next slide, please. And here you can see this is pre-tazemetostat and this is post-tazemetostat. The PET-CT showed almost metabolic CR with few, a bit of uptake, but patient had excellent response, excellent symptomatic response. Almost 3 months or 4 months with tazemetostat are over. Second patient also had good response. Next slide, please. About eribulin, next slide. This is a drug which is approved in liposarcoma. It was approved in 2016. Next slide, please. It was compared to dacarbazine. The primary endpoint was overall survival. Next slide, please. However, PFS benefit was not there. As of now, from our institute, we have limited data about eribulin, but we are compiling and it will come with some soon. Next slide, please. Next slide, please. So this is the liposarcoma subgroup which is getting benefited, while leiomyosarcoma subgroup had no benefit. Next slide, please. What about immunotherapy? So immunotherapy is again a new concept in soft tissue sarcoma. Next slide, please. And as you can see, next slide, please. So this is the SARC-028 study, one of the first study of immunotherapy in sarcoma. The best response for pembrolizumab was in undifferentiated pleomorphic sarcoma. In liposarcoma, it was 30%. In synovial sarcoma, it was 20%. In UPS, it was 7 out of 40. It was almost 4 out of 10 patients, which was 40%. Another paper came up with ASPS, in which response rate by atezolizumab is almost 42%. Next slide, please. So we have given immunotherapy till 9 patients. Next slide, please. So this is the kind of tumors in which we have given immunotherapy. Next slide, please. They are all chemo-refractory. And next slide, please. The response, next slide, please. In three patients, there have been prolonged, previous slide, please. Of 9 patients, in three patients, there had been prolonged response. In two patients, excellent partial response for more than a year. In one patient, stable disease for more than a year. I'll just come to which histologies are we telling about. Next slide, please. So this is a case of pleomorphic sarcoma. Next slide, please. So patient was too much symptomatic. PD-L1 was 25%. Next slide, please. And this is the mass. When patient was too symptomatic, we start with the pembrolizumab and pazopanib, and patient had almost CR. Patient is almost 1.5 years post this therapy, and we stopped pembrolizumab somewhere, and still patient is in CR till now. This is July scan, but later on, current scan, few days back, was also in CR. Next slide, please. Similarly, this is our ASPS patient. ASPS is a sarcoma which doesn't respond to anything, responds only to immunotherapy. The young girl, present with lung mets, present with pelvic mass, and now you can see after 22 cycles of nivolumab, her current response assessment is pending. Next slide, please. So I think in this short time, I've almost covered everything: pazopanib, trabectedin, eribulin, histologies, and a lot of histologies, and the upcoming role of immunotherapy in two sarcoma, especially UPS and ASPS. Next slide, please. And my last slide, please. So I am really thankful to all my colleagues. I'm really thankful to all the departments. And finally, this slide shows everything that we don't have now, a sarcoma-specific treatment for any line. We just have histology-specific treatment. Thank you. Thanks a lot.